let's talk about Grimm.
Let's talk about Grimm, baby. What do you want to know?
I want to know, now that Kenneth is out of the picture, or Kendall as we referred to him.
Kendall.
He was a Kendall. He was way too pretty.
Too pretty?
Too
Is
pretty.
Is there such a thing?
Yes, yeah. Kenneth. Now that Kendall's done, I'm not letting go.
No.
What can we expect happening with the Royals?
Well, I think that little storyline will take a rest for a minute as they'll regroup, which they'll have to have because half of them are dead now.
Yeah.
But I think we're going to be more Portland-centric and we're going to kind of focus on the, you know, localized situation, politics, Wesen. There's a whole insurgency that's about to happen and all the stuff that we've been alluding to over four seasons is going to bubble over and cause complete mess for all of us.
All right, let's talk about the baby mama drama.
Baby mama drama.
Okay, so yeah.
It's turned into a Maury Povich episode, hasn't it?
Yeah, it really has.
I've slept with Nick's fiance.
Yeah.
I've had a baby with Nick's current girlfriend-ish,
no,
whatever she is.
Baby mama. She's
baby
not
mama.
Girlfriend.
Whatever, I'm romanticizing
no,
it.
She's meant to be with Meisner.
She's meant to be with Meisner.
Yeah,
all right.
Please, don't do this to me.
All right, I'm sorry.
Okay.
So yes, we've had a lot of, it seems like we've been sharing women, or at least I've been kind of making a mess of his relationships.
That's right, we don't mind.
Anyway.
But are we going to get some sort of resolution, or are you all going to move into a house together and have a Brady Bunch situation?
I don't see that happening.
Which
and
part?
First of all, I don't even know where my daughter is, so let's just, you know, talk about that for
She's
a second.
She's safe with Meisner.
Is she, though? Is anyone safe with Meisner?
Yes, yes.
And so, no, we're going to, yeah, no, I think we're it's going to be a very interesting dynamic. I actually find it really fun to watch how Adalind has gone from one end of the spectrum to the other and is, you know, now this sort of likable, sympathetic character that needs our help. And so it's very interesting to see their relationship develop. But I don't know what's going to happen. I imagine a lot of conflict.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I imagine.
Are you a fan of the Nick and Adalind relationship that the fans want? Or would you prefer Renard with
I like Renard as a lone wolf.
Yeah,
I think he's more interesting that way. He's too complicated and too difficult. And, you know, it's just I think he's got too much on his plate to really entertain a genuine relationship. I mean, the guy's got his hand in, you know, so many different things, and it's just unlikely that love is one of those.
Next season, lots of baby mama drama.
Yeah, even in the first three episodes that I've read, there's a lot of, like, Nick and Adalind already, like, we gotta figure this out.
Yeah.
So, that relationship is being established, and it's just interesting. It's really interesting. I think they're doing a good job, kind of, you know, because Nick and Adalind kind of have stuff in common now that she has no one. She's lost everyone. He's lost everyone. So I think it gives them more of a level playing field, like a way to communicate at least. So.
Yeah. And is Adalind still non-Hexenbeast with the repressed Hexenbeast?
Right. So she's not a Hexenbeast, but we don't know how long, like, does that wear off?
Mm-hmm.
And she's done being a Hexenbeast. Like, she's really wanting to just commit to raising this kid, so.
Okay. And do you believe, you as Claire, do you believe that Nick and Adalind should get together?
I don't. I haven't decided. How's that for an answer?
Because you want her to be with Meisner, right? Meisner!
You're going to be so happy.
I was so happy to see him.
You're going
to
be so happy come season five.
That's the best news I've heard all day.
Yeah, I will tell you that much.
Is he going to be shirtless?
Oh, I don't know about that. Well, I'll just put in a request for
Please,
you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I know that we, last season, and I think the season before, we had a lot of, I want to say, chemical use for Adalind.
Yes, yes. Adalind was basically a freshman dude for a lot of last season.
Are we expecting more chemical use?
I hope not.
She's a mom. Yeah,
yeah,
she's two.
Yeah. She's a mom. I think she's got to get her shit together, really. And no more drugs.
Have you told the writers?
Now that I am a mom in real life, I can be like, hey guys, so drugs off the table, not good while breastfeeding. A beer here or there is fine, but hard drugs, not recommended.
Yeah, it's off the table.
You know, not good for the milk supply.
We're so excited about the new season and all the crazy stuff. But first, we got to talk about how are you doing with Juliet gone?
Oh, I know. It's so sad. The show won't be the same without Juliet. She did a very good job in becoming
horribly evil.
Yeah.
And she was a hexen beast. She turned into something new, so.
The fans turned on her. They really, like, hated her.
All you have to do is burn down the trailer and have my mother decapitated, and suddenly the fans hate you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, is Kelly really gone?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The fans were not sure.
With the head?
Yeah.
I mean, if anything's possible, I suppose.
Yeah. You should read the conspiracy theories, I'm telling you.
What are they?
They're that the baby, that Diana made it, like, make you see that the head is there, but it's not really a head.
Oh. Well, I think she's dead.
Okay, awesome.
She's on another show right now. Right. Here's a good way to figure this stuff out here at home. Is the actor currently working on another enormous project? They're not probably coming back then. That's a little that'll guide your conspiracy theories, because there can be good conspiracy theories in our show.
Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about Trouble. Is Trouble
episode one? It gets bad for her.
Wait, what does that mean?
The first shot, I should say, within 5 seconds of the new episode, it's like bad news for Trouble.
So now that there's a baby on the way for Nick and Adalind, the fans are like really excited about Nick and Adalind together. Is that a thing that we can look forward to? Because I'm hesitant.
I'm hesitant, though it's... We're parenting this kid, so it's kind of happening.
Oh,
I know.
I don't like it.
Well, it's like, if it happens, it has to happen very, very slowly. But I don't know if it's ever going to get there all the way. Like, the way I currently see it is that, like, this kid's all I have. She's the mother. I can't, like, screw that up. So it's more, like, professional, and then it's all about the baby.
Okay. That's good.
That's how I play it.
Good. Because I know that...
I've only read 3 episodes, though.
Fair enough. I'm a Meisner fan, so with Meisner's return, is there going to be like a love triangle-y thing over the baby?
I haven't seen anything like that, though I know he's involved heavily in the plot right now in a different way.
Okay.
There's going to be kind of like a Wesen uprising.
Okay. I know that last season we got real close to the, like, you know, human world finding out about Wesen. Is that where we're headed this season? Are we going to have more of the council coming in?
I don't know. I mean, I've only read three eps, but, like, I doubt that's probably where it's going to go. I think we're going to have more human world not knowing about Wesen.
And I know there's answers about the keys have been teased. What can you tell us about that?
I can't. I don't know. I honestly don't know anything about the keys. It's not dealt with in the early part of the season, but...
That's good to know.
But the Adalind Nick stuff, definitely Meisner. A lot of stuff there. Huge stuff with Trouble right away.
Yeah.
It'll be fun.
Do you have any theories about the keys yourself?
No, not really. I don't know. I mean, it's so complex. There's, like, so many things going on.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Hey, let's talk about next season. We ended the season with Chavez showing up, and who knows what happened. Like, we actually don't know what happened.
Yeah.
So what can you tease about the premiere? Because we know nothing.
Right. Well, it starts seconds after it ends,
awesome.
Where Nick is holding Juliet in his arms, and then a group of very scary people come in, and... they take Trouble, they take Juliet, and they take the head, and Juliet's body, rather. And
I was going to ask.
No,
I was like,
Juliet's body, her, the head, and Trouble gets kidnapped, and they drug Nick, and he wakes up to an empty house, and so that kicks off a hell-bent quest to find out what the hell happened. so that happens right away, and then Chavez's character really redefines the show. We really are rebooting the series. Juliet's death and the obliteration of the royals is going to create some very epic storylines. It's exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're like all like reinvigorated, you know.
Good.
Yeah.
And we know that Rosalie has some sort of connection with the council and with, you know, the old way of the world.
Yeah.
Are we going to get to see more of that this season?
Oh, I think for sure. You know, the resistance is a big part of what's
coming up, and she comes from a government family. Her father and brother were part of the council, part of the resistance, and, you know, I like how Rosalie is always a little cagey when that subject comes up, and so I think we're going to get more information this season on that. Yeah.
Speaking of the resistance, what can you tell me, because everyone knows I'm a Meisner fan, what can you tell us about Meisner?
Well, you saw Meisner.
I know. I was dying.
I mean, I love Meisner too. No, Meisner, yeah, he's around.
He's around.
Yeah. I mean, that was a loaded scene you saw. There's a future in that.
Okay.
Yes. I am speaking in weird code.
But the fact that there's a future makes me so happy.
Yeah.
Thank
and
you so much.
And also his abs need to be seen more. I mean, it's just like, come on.
I just want it noted that I didn't say it, and that's what's important. Thank you
Damien.
So much.
Okay.
Let's talk about the new season of Grimm.
Okay.
It seems like Monrosalie
yes.
has not yet caught a break. And
no. We had a honeymoon after I was captured and beaten up and stuck in the woods and almost burned to the stake.
Right.
And then we came back and we tried to chill out for a second, but that didn't go so well. And yeah.
So can we hope for a break of some sort?
It's
not
very dramatic, though, is it? The break part.
Yeah, you gotta have a calm before the storm.
The calm lasts about a half a glass of wine's worth of length, and then the shit hits the fan again.
Yeah.
And, you know, Nick is in a really bad way. He is, you know, his mother's head is in a box, his girlfriend is dead, and he's out for blood, and we got to keep him from doing something really crazy.
Yeah. So Monroe is kind of still struggling with some PTSD. Are we going to see that evolve this season?
I think that the idea of... I think it will manifest... I think there's a big, big story arc coming where you'll see Monroe... You'll see him, how he handles being threatened again. And if it's a fight or flight type of thing. But there's a big story arc that I can't say too much about. Elizabeth Rodriguez comes back.
Okay.
She plays Chavez, who's an FBI agent who's also Wesen.
Right.
And her return harbinges a whole new shift in a direction that is new, but also really true to the roots of the show.
Yeah. All right, before I let you go, is she part of an organization that we've already met? Can you tell us that?
I don't even know.
Oh. Ooh, secrets.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, look, I just say words, you know. I don't write it. So honestly, I don't know.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
So you've always been like Nick's, really his like crutch that he leans on.
Yes.
And we now have Wu involved.
Yes.
Is there going to be some tension between Hank and Wu as the like go-to?
No, see, I'm the physical crutch. And like Wu is the cerebral crutch.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like Wu is like, but like he's like, I'm like the guy on the scene. I'm Johnny on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
Wu is like, okay, back at the station, Wu has discovered the secret something that we need to get the secret out of the sauce.
Yeah. Well, because Wu's got Wu's clues.
Exactly. And Wu's got some Wu genius.
Yeah.
I've got Hank physicality.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so, like, I'm the physical presence. And like I said, Wu is the more cerebral presence.
Okay. Because I know
he's scientific.
The fans were concerned.
Oh, no. Listen, that's why it's called a team. We all have things, you know, we all have our strengths and our weaknesses.
Yeah.
So you have to work together.
Okay.
Sort of like a Voltron.
Yeah.
Like Wonder Twins or something.
Awesome.
The Justice League.
You
right?
Keep naming teams.
Just more teams, but that's all I have.
Okay. So I know that, like, romance has slightly been...
Romance.
Yeah.
Sheer delight. How sweet.
Yeah.
I've got to find me a girl to make my life complete. She can scratch my back, get cozy, and huddle. Anyway.
But I'm right here. I'm right here,
you know,
man.
I got talent, baby.
Are you going to sing this season? Is that what you're teasing?
I sing the body electric. I celebrate the me yet to come. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There we go. Let's keep going.
All right. So we've only got three. You've only read about three episodes yet this
yes.
season.
I've only read one.
Oh.
We have. Yeah.
But there are three.
There are three so far.
All right.
There'll be 22.
All right. What can you tease us about the premiere?
Juliet's dead. But she's in a casket dead.
Oh.
Like pale dead, like the blood's gone out of her dead. Like okay. She's like formaldehyde dead.
All right. Thank you so much. Let's talk about the new season.
Yeah.
So I know the fans were worried that they're, now that Wu is in the know, mm-hmm. there's going to be some sort of, issues. No, that can't happen. It's not going to happen. We're not allowing it. But that Wu and Hank are now, you know, kind of doing the same thing for Nick.
Oh, interesting question.
Yeah.
Interesting question. I've always come, as a sergeant, mm-hmm. I've always come with a background for the crimes.
Right.
And that was always my job. So now I'm going to come with a background for the Wesen crimes.
Yeah.
And I think that is going to be my job, which is very different from what Hank does.
Right.
Completely different. They solve the crimes together. I bring them the information.
Yeah.
So I've always been the information guy. And I'm hoping to be, like, the most top-notch, awesome information guy you've ever seen.
Is Wu going to digitize the
I know,
stuff
right?
yet?
People have asked me that. They were like, did he not scan the books? You know?
I feel like
but
Wu
I feel like
do it.
But that's what I'm saying. I'm giving that suggestion to the producers. Let's go let's do the technology. Yeah. And Wu can do all this stuff. This is what he's really good at.
Yeah.
So I would love that, which would make it even more different from what Hank does.
Right.
You know, and I feel like that's you know, he's always been Nick's partner. So I'm always not there as that part. But now what I love is it's going to be emotional turmoil for Nick.
Yeah.
I can't believe I just said that.
That sounds so mean.
That's terrible.
I love that
but listen,
he's going to have trouble.
He was not there for me when I was in the psychiatric ward, okay?
Seriously. What a douchebag.
But I'm loving that I have that human aspect to be able to bring to the table, because now I know all the stuff.
Right.
So
Wu has, as you said, always been from the detective, mm-hmm. from the sergeant-y police
right.
standpoint. How is he dealing with the fact that we're being very vague with the law? I love when he explains things like, I guess he had an explosive device.
Yeah, no, he is so game.
That's
to like,
crazy.
You know, maybe he had like an explode bomb on him or something.
Right.
But listen, it's a whole new world that I'm so excited about that has taken over all this other stuff. And I'm like, I'm going to be part of this team.
Yeah.
I'm going to be part of this new world. You can't unsee things.
Yeah.
So how do you go with it? You know, you can't do that. I mean, if something happens, something happens. So how do we stay? It's kind of like the fine line, which is great. See, you're good at this. That's why you're good at this. Because you make us think as characters, as actors, how do I balance that? You know, being a cop and being the best cop ever, trying to be the best cop ever with now this whole other world that kind of breaks laws.
Yeah, and
you
can't
have
be
to.
Explained.
That and can't be explained. So how do you explain these things to, say, the FBI presence that will be around during episode one?
Yeah, tell us about the FBI presence that'll be around in episode one.
There will be an FBI presence.
Okay.
During episode one, a large FBI presence.
Yeah. Is that's all you can say?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well then let me ask, is Wu gonna ever get promoted from sergeant?
First, I think he needs a Wu-mans, and that would help it.
A Wu-mans would be great.
I know, right?
Right now, I mean, right now he just has Wu's clues.
I know, he has Wu's clues, and he
Wu's
has his donuts.
Clues. Yeah.
sassy
yeah. Wu.
Wu's got this, yeah, Wu, yeah, I like that about Wu.
Yeah.
He has more sass than I do in real life. And I like that. No, I can't be that sassy in real life, but on screen, it's like killing people when you're a bad guy. You
yeah.
can do it on screen. You love it. You relish it. I love that I can relish his sass, like even in his walk. I love
yeah.
that. So, what was the question?
It was about promoting.
We could talk all day.
Yeah, we could. He needs a promotion.
Right. But he, well, yeah, I think, you know, the captain's part of the team now. He's privy to what Wu knows, and Wu's privy to what the captain is. So I think maybe that might be in the works. I'm going to suggest that.
Yeah.
I'm going to suggest all your suggestions.
Good. All right, last
them.
Question
yes.
about the Wu-mans.
Yes.
What kind of partner does Wu need?
Rosalie. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, my God, that was terrible.
Oh,
no,
the Rosalie fans are going to be so mad.
I have said there's nothing sexier than a Fuchsbau who is a badass. She's really sexy, and then she's really good at what she does.
We know that the entire after show team agrees that Rosalie, the Fuchsbau, is so sexy
yeah.
and badass.
Yeah, sexy badass. And then you need to add sarcastic to that.
Yeah.
So someone can banter with me.
Mm.
Have a little more sass with the Wu.
I love it. I love it. We're fighting for this Wu man.
Yes.
Thank you so much. It was great to see you. Let's start with the very, very simple question. We're going to hit the 100th episode this season. What do we have planned? Something special? A musical episode?
That's in the works, but maybe not for the 100th episode. However, we are finally going to answer the keys, and that should be the 100th episode, which Bert is going to direct.
The answer is, but we're going to answer. We're going to find out. We'll find out something.
We'll make it a very big episode.
Okay, but you guys don't know what the keys are yet?
You know, when we get about 8 days away from that thing shooting, we'll know what they are.
Okay, I'll accept that. I'll accept that. We want to know about Trouble, everyone's favorite Trouble. She is our favorite Trouble. Are we going to get a lot of Trouble? Is she a regular yet?
She's not a regular per se, but you're going to get a lot of Trouble.
Yeah, I'd like her to be a regular.
Yeah. What's holding her back?
Tell NBC to make her a regular.
NBC, make Trouble a regular. We want more Jacqueline Tabani. We love her.
And she's going to be impactful either way.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Lots to do.
We were teased in the panel that Nick is going to lose something. I think he's lost a lot already. Can you tease a little bit about what it is?
He's going to lose his keys.
And pants. Yeah.
And he doesn't know where they are. And he has to really search for them hard.
Like the keys to his car?
Yeah. And he's got his on
huge
foot.
Arc.
It's huge arc. He gets on a bicycle now.
Oh, my God.
It's unbelievable.
It's so Portland.
It's so Portland.
It is.
I want to know what you can tell us about Meisner. Everyone else has been telling me that Meisner is back for something important. How long is Meisner staying, and when will he be shirtless? I love Meisner. You guys should watch our after show where I don't shut up about Meisner.
Great.
Yeah.
Great. Well, did you like Meisner in the helicopter during the King out?
Killing the King. Wasn't that great? Yeah. Him and the little girl together and her
but
smiling.
You want him to take his shirt off.
Yeah. You said it. I didn't say that. But obviously.
He's definitely in the mix.
He'll be in the mix, and he'll be doing a lot of fun things.
Awesome. I know the fans are really excited about Nick and Adalind getting together and that becoming a thing. I'm not really a fan of this, but everyone else wants them together. What can you tell us about that relationship?
They will be getting together for a little while. Yeah, they have a kid together.
This child, they have to take care of this child. But what comes after that is anybody's guess. And she could, her powers, remember she only took a suppressant. Her powers could come back and she could flip the tables on them. Anything might happen.
Okay.
And we don't really know what's going to happen, so we don't have to tell you.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, when will we find out about the keys?
100.
Episode 100.
Okay, that's the 12th episode, right?
That's correct.
All right, so we only have to sit for 12 episodes till we get the answers we've been waiting for since season 1.
We've already written 3, so we better get to work.
Yeah, we better figure it out.
And you can confirm that Kelly and Juliet are both gone. They're really dead.
I can confirm that Juliet Silverton and Kelly are gone.
Well, we only had Kelly's head to begin with. We didn't really have I don't know where the rest of her body is.
Hey, without a body, she could be alive.
Somewhere in Portland, yeah.
Awesome. I also heard that the Loch Ness Monster is coming. Can you tease us a little bit about that?
Well, we like to explain phenomena on Grimm, and we did a Gluenvolk episode a while back that explained cattle mutilation and aliens, and this is going to explain the Loch Ness Monster, what it really is, where it really comes from.
Not the Loch Ness Monster per se.
Not per se, but a thing like that.
Okay, awesome. Thank you guys so much. I just got so many answers. I'm so excited. Thank you guys.